Hey there and welcome back to Dave Flynn Photography, and today we're just going to do another Lightroom edit, just a basic one. So open up your Lightroom, select the image that you want, a raw file obviously. In this case I've got a picture of my pussycat, this is pause, and we're just going to give it a basic edit. So I'm going to reset it back to how it was. Let me see, that's the original file, so straight out of the camera, and you can see it's got like a warm tone to it. So immediately I'm just going to stay in this top bit of the develop module and just adjust some of the sliders in here. So first of all, we're going to just go to the white balance. We can keep it as the shot and adjust the color temperatures here automatically or manually if we want. So go to as shot, click on flash, and you can see that's kind of reduced the yellows in the image a little bit. It's even moved the slider down to a nice cooler tone. So then the next bit, I'm just going to brighten up his eyes here a little bit, and by doing that you click on the shadows and just drag to the right a touch, and then it'll just brighten up the shadows a tiny bit. You don't want to go too much because it might bring out too much detail, especially in the eyebrow here. So I'm just going to zoom back out, play with the blacks. Don't want to make him too dark. Just bring it up to about 17. And the whites are fine as it is. I'm just much. And I think that's it. He looks kind of cute now. I might just alter his nose here a tiny bit. So we just zoom in on the nose and just bring up a teensy bit of pink in there. That's it. Okay, now we're just going to open the same file in Photoshop. So let's close this down. Open Photoshop. And here we have the same image. And now I'm just going to make some minor adjustments in Photoshop. The first thing you want to do is make a background copy. So this is the original file here. Simply drag on the background and bring it into the new layers palette down the bottom, and now you've got a copy. So any adjustments you make, if you really mess up, you can just delete that layer and then start again. So I'm just going to zoom in, and I'm just going to brighten up his eyes a little bit. By doing that, you click on the burn tool over here, and the dodge, you want to select the dodge one. Dodge is where it kind of increases the highlights in the area. So the area we want to select is the shadow. You see this tiny little bit of shadow in his eye there. So I'm just going to click on shadows. Let's set the exposure down. 6 is good enough, because the longer you press on the mouse button, the more it will react with the image. So we just want to give it a few quick strokes around the shadowy areas. Just reduce your brush size. And you can just see now it's brightened up those darker areas in his eye. Now again, we want to go into burn tool and again make some adjustments, this time to the shadow area. We're going to burn him in, so darken him. So reduce the brush size, and again the same settings. I'm just going to paint over the black bits of his eye. Okay, and now back to dodge again, and this time we're going to select highlights, and I'm just going to paint over the highlights in his eye here, the window light, just to give it a bit more prominence. Same here on the right. Just keep clicking, as you can see it just changes it. Now there's a before and after, before and after, tiny little adjustments there. If you want to, you can go further into the image and change the tone of his nose here, and just tidy up any areas that you see that might be stray or a bit wonky. Your cats are funny for having little wonky bits on them. So like this eyelash here, eyebrow, whisker needs adjusting. So I'm just going to click on this one. This is the healing brush tool, and we just want to leave on spot healing. It's only a tiny little area, and just drag your brush down and let go. There you go, it's gone. And you can tidy up any stray little bits. There you go. And then a little bit there in his eye, and a little bit there in his eye. And now, click on fit screen, and we're just going to fix this piece up here. The way I did that is get the clone stamp tool and increase your brush size. To increase your brush, by the way, you can either go up here and choose your brush size here, or use the bracket keys on the keyboard and they increase or decrease the size of your brush much quicker. So you one hand on your mouse or your tablet pen, and the other hand on the keyboard, and adjust as you need. So here, what you do is you select an area of the image. We're going to select this area so it matches, or this area, and press the Alt key. What that's going to do now is sample that area. So we now have a sample of the area. So you can see that if we bring it up here, it's going to paint it in. One thing I did do is that the brush here, you can see it's very obvious that I've just painted that in. So undo. You need to choose a soft brush. This is a hard brush. So click on soft brush. And now sample the area. Let's sample this area. And when you paint now, you can't really see. So the opacity here is set at 41%. If you bring it up to 100, you're going to get this kind of effect. And paint straight in. If we reduce the opacity, you can go back. Because the opacity is reduced, you can just paint it in gradually. It kind of matches in, blends in better. So I'm just going to carry on with that. Paint around that area. And then sample as you go. Reduce the brush size for the intricate areas around here. And then finally, just fill it out a little bit up here. It doesn't look so obvious. Okay. We're done. Zoom out on them a little bit. It looks much better. And then if you wanted to add more color and tone, you can easily just select that same layer, change your color balance here. You've got your level adjustments here. Brightness and contrast and hue and saturation. So for example, you click on hue saturation. What that does is puts like a mask on top, which will affect every layer underneath it. But because we want to keep the original background layer, what you do is hold down the Alt key just above that layer there, see? And you press your click on your mouse, and now any adjustments you make will only affect this layer here, and the background one will remain untouched. So again, you can go in, change the hue and saturation. You can see it change in purple, or brighten it up and make it green, and go all abstract and make a crazy looking cat. Or you can just make it more neutral. Saturation again, so you can bring up a bit more of the color, but it's going to kind of bring the background back to the original shot and really make his nose red rather than pink. So you don't do any of that too much. I'm going to bring it to about there. And then any lightness you want to bring in, just to make your color pop a little bit. So increase it to 3. And that's it. That's the final edit. So you close this. And usually I flatten the image. Unless it's a big file or one for a client. I will save the file now as a PSD file so I can come back to it later and make changes. But in this case, it's just a picture of my cat on the sofa. I'm finished. I'm going to flatten the image now. And that's it, the image is now complete and done, so you can go ahead and save it. So that's basic image editing in Lightroom or Photoshop. I hope you've learned something. Anything you want to ask, just ask in the comments below. Please subscribe. It's great to have you viewing my videos, and thank you for your support.